Jangan apa? Hello.
Yes,
yes. Yes. Everybody is ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. This is an extensive part of my presentation. The use of stainless steel in structures and certain phenomenon which has to be gone through. There are two small audio-visual presentations with it. Okay. In the preface, the past 15 years, the stainless steel is in construction, it is in use. And historically, initially, we will use as an, what you call it as an, which is a carbonated steel or something like that. But initially, it has got a high material cost. And so that's why it is limited in use. Nowadays, we have emergences of design code and better awareness for the additional benefits of the stainless steel and transition towards the sustainability and bringing more widespread use in the conventional structures. The important phenomenon that this material, stainless steel as a material, is to be used, it is because of its Young's modulus and yield strength, because we have to think about this particular material. The fundamental difference exists, such as the nature of stress strain curve. I will show you that stress strain curve and how it is important in that way, and response to the cold work and elevated temperature. So these are the two other phenomena that because of which it gives is the ultimate the serviceability, and the fire limit is also on the higher side. But 9x11 has a threshold that squash out this fire limit state and something like that. Okay, This stainless steel is traditionally an extravagant solution to the structural engineering problem. The reason for this is because it is not used because of high initial material cost, limited structural design guidance, and the sections available which are not standardized, and the lack of understanding with the additional benefits of the stainless steel. So that's why it is not so popular right now, today itself. In India is also, it is not so popular. Nowadays, it taking shape up. Okay. In 1912 and 13, the first structure was built. And it is in that era, it is used as an rustless steel. That is the thing which is initially it is called it. Then this Ernest Stewart is popularized the term like stainless. The world is chemical compositions. There are different kinds of chemical composition. Hello.
We can hear you.
Shall I continue or shall I stop?
So you can continue, sir.
Okay. So how this material it is happening and which is available in the market? Various chemical compositions, and it is accordingly this material is graded. The name the few, it is for like austenitic, ferritic, duplex, that is as austenitic and ferritic, martensitic, and the precipitation and hardening. So there are different kinds, which the different chemical compositions are there, means how much chromium, how much nickel is there, how much magnesium is there, accordingly percentage wise it varies, accordingly the grade which is given, accordingly the performance is also different as such. These are the first one, the austenitic and the dulex is most commonly used in the construction. Otherwise the rest of the things are used in for the different purposes and so on and so forth. So I given here a little bit information about this austenitic, that is the stainless steel. It has got 17-18% of chromium and 8% of nickel, and it is mostly used because of it is a corrosion resistance. And second was a duplex stainless steel, typically 23-22% of chromium and 4-5% nickel. And it is used for the other purposes, some part which is also used in the construction itself. Now these are the structural products which is come out and which is available in the market, like it is in the plate form, which is in the sheet form, it is in the strip form, tube, bars, cold form, hot rolled, so structural sections, then cast, fastening, and supply chain, and accordingly how the services are available, what kind of technical things which is happen, and accordingly what kind of product which we can get and which is to be used. Now here are the visuals about the cold rolled, then the strip in the form, plate form, sheet form, and now these are the certain things which is available in the. Other are the bars, tie bars, the threaded bars, and the custom size as we have so many things. Sunbreakers are there, and handles and so on. These are the long products. Future in the material because of the sustainability and so forth. So other thing which is also taken into account, but these products are not coming in the market, but they can be available. It can be available. All these things. Reconditioning of the product is also a necessary part of the sustainability. Reprocess is also one of it. We also required the higher strength for the thinner product. We initially, it has got the thicker product. So it is also going to be added in the cost. So certain qualities related to duplex grade, which can be available right now for this purpose, and it is nowadays which is available. Now the structural members, now which is the important phenomenon for us while designing. For the structural members, most commonly used are the cold forms. And it is at the low investment and are suitable for light structures and applications. This is also high structural efficiency, which it gives us to us. Yes, this is an important phenomenon. That's why we have to choose stainless steel as a material. Stress strain behavior. So there are two curves which we can see. The dotted curve, which is for the carbon steel, and the plain one, which is of stainless steel. And once the stresses and the strains, this is a stress and strain graph. So as the stress and the strain increases, the what we see the strength in the stainless steel, which is also rises. But for the carbon steel, means the carbon is more in percentage as such. So it is at a particular point, it is straight in line, and which is a constant in that way. So for the foreign austenitic steel, steel grade, the ductility, stress and strain, that is a fracture, it is 40% to 60% as compared to 20 to 30% in carbon steel. Now, this is an important phenomenon for us. What is the difference between a normal steel and the stainless steel? This is a difference, and because of which we have to think about this material as such. Then the corner material, when which we have a press cold, these the corners are also rigid one, and which gives you a proper strain. And so on and so forth. Corrosion resistance, which is because it is an important phenomenon now, as compared to steel, it is because we have to add it in chromium and nickel accordingly. It gives me an corrosion resistance. This also is an important. There are five different kinds of corrosion, which is there. One is abrasive pitting. Third is Creview and integranular and the galvanic corrosion. These are the five different kinds of corrosion which is to be happens. Most of the things are doesn't work related to stainless steel. It should be noted that the certain environments such those containing high concentration of chlorides and suitable grade should be selected accordingly. Now, this is an important phenomenon because nowadays the stainless steel is also used for what you call it as an refinery of the sugar and the milk and so on and so forth, where we require a certain quality of material itself. So that is also available. So this is also used for the erection of the erection of the structures related to that activity. Factor influencing material choice, there are a number of other issues like cost, which we have seen. The initial cost of the stainless steel was higher. Nowadays, it is because of high strength and thinner qualities, it gives the lower cost as such. However, there are a number of other issues that should be included to comparison for the cost. Aesthetics, yes, we have to play. Historically, the aesthetics of the stainless steel has been an important factor and the specification of the structural applications. It appeals principally due to the surface finishes and the ability to retain the appearance without deterioration over time. So deterioration, there is no almost deterioration of the material as such. Okay, this is an example of the first structure which was built in 1936 in New York. This is a Chrysler building, and still it is there. So, in despite of the aggressive atmosphere, proximity to the ocean remains bright and clean. So, it is in the vicinity of the nearby the ocean and something. Durability, yes. With appropriate selection of the material grade, it may be an austenitic or the what you call it as an other material. Corrosion resistance of stainless steel quality, that is also an important phenomenon for having a durability. Minimum maintenance, yes. This material required minimum maintenance. And design for structure of 100 years, now that we can achieve with using such kind of material. This is another two important graphs as such. Elevated temperature means the what happens when the temperature rises. Now there are two different graph which is available for us, where one shows the strength and the other shows the stiffness. And as the what you call it as temperature rises in both the cases, then compared with the carbon steel, the stainless steel sustain more. Sorry. So this is also one of the, but this phenomenon is have changed now because of the 9/11 twin tower structure collapse. Ductility and impact resistance. Okay, this austenitic grade offer very high ductility and impact resistance. So that's why it is more commonly used in the structures. Examples are offshore structures and so on and so forth. A study shows that about the sustainability of the adopting the stainless steel for the structural frame in the seismic region, that is also an important phenomenon, where it concluded that stainless steel is viable alternative for the carbon steels. Nowadays, the reinforcement is also available in stainless steel. So stainless steel used as an reinforcement. Reuse and recycle. Okay, this is an important phenomenon when the structure doesn't have any further more life, then the waste material, it is to be properly treated. So one is a landfilling, and this is also to be a financial and environmental advantage as such. In case of stainless steel, the remelting of the scrap is also can be done and can be reused as such. Now here is an one study which is available, that whole life costing means there are three different kinds of structures which was built by the carbon steel, aluminium and the stainless steel, and they are properly evaluated, and there are certain silent features about this. The consideration which is given for this evaluation means analyzing these structures using these different kinds of materials, like material cost, maintenance, corrosion, process losing during the maintenance, fire resistant, and other potential cost of saving. So all are the what you call analyzing tools as such. The study concluded that aluminum and a stainless steel result is a significant for the life cycle cost saving as compared to the carbon steel. Further, the combination of the economy and the fire safety benefits that stainless steel offered were unequaled by the alternative material, means it is more commonly. So that's the thing which was studied and properly have an analyzing. So that's why this material plays an important role nowadays, which can be suggested by the architect. Okay, what are the things which is to be done in the structural design? So generally, the historical stainless steel design rules, initially it was formed, it is based on the assumptions of the on the carbon steel behavior and the modifications. So whatever the thing which was earlier done in the as in rules and regulations or what is the that particular thing, it is means the design standards are based on this carbon steel and its behavior and modifications. Now earlier, now these are the different things which is happening in all over the world, that in 1968 and in 74 the American stainless steel standard first thing which is coming to an existence. Okay, in European countries it is happening from 1991 to 2002. Now this is happening in European countries. What you call it as an 88, this SI undertaken to development and recommendation for design for stainless steel in Europe. So 88 onwards, the design code has established, and ultimately it comes to in 1994 this first design rules published by Euro INOX. Then in 1995, the Japanese stainless steel and the structural design standards were issued, and further it has got a further development in that. Okay, in Africa it is happens in 2001. But this is a world scenario. Now what happens in the in case of India, we have so many IS codes. Now we'll just go through this. Now this is the list of the IS code which is available for us for the designing and designing purposes for different construction nodes and everything. Now this is a list. Okay, so one, this is another one, the different kinds of bolt, technical supply condition, roll cutting. So for the different purposes and different things, there's these IS codes exist for us and which is available. Okay, then the structural design, we have to take into account the material strength and the stiffness. The material properties of the stainless steel vary with the chemical composition, that is one which we have seen, the product type, level of cold work which is happening on, means the processing which is happening, material thickness, which is also an important phenomenon, direction of rolling, longitudinal or transverse, because of which the strength and stiffness may change, and loading, direction of the loading, means tensile load, how it is, or compression load, how it is to be acting on the material. So accordingly it is changes. So commonly adopted, it is an this is particular grade. This is also what you call it as nomenclated as EN 1.4301 or EN 1.4401. This is the nomenclature which is given it to the austenitic stainless steel grade. The cross section. So while designing the structural design, we have to think about the section thickness of the material. It has to be taken into account, which is referred in European guidelines, so on and so forth. Member design. How to member design? The behavior of the stainless steel members differ from carbon steel. So it is also changing from code to code. European code, it is different. US code, it recommends based on the carbon steel. In Australia and New Zealand, it is adopted from the US. Serviceability. For the determination of the deflection of the stainless steel members, we can take into account the stress strain characteristics and the modulus of the electricity that is to be taken into account. Deflections are calculated based on effective cross sections and reduction in the modulus electricity. This is a little bit technical, but just we have to go on through this particular information. That's all. Joints. Now, this is an important phenomenon for us. So, how the structural members are jointed together. It is by means of welding, bolting, and other fastening and fasteners and something like that. This bolting and the thing, it is not much common due to certain problems related to that. So nowadays, you can see only the welding, which is happening everywhere. The basic design philosophy is no difference from the carbon steel joints. Is the logic is the same. The common grade of the stainless steel are readily weldable, which is an important. Austenitic steel grade welded easily due to the similarities in the metallurgical structures and temperatures. So the metals within these two are the same. The structural behavior of the stainless steel joint is similar to that of the carbon steel joints. However, general design aspects that are to consider in particular minimize the risk of corrosion, which is an important phenomenon in case of joint. The structural behavior of the stainless steel joints is similar to that of the carbon steel joints. This is also another phenomenon which is taken into account. Now, this is a separate, what you call it, is a small chapter related to joining and fabrication of the steel. Now, these are the processes and these are the things which is available. So, applicable of the joint process. One, we have a welding. So, there are one, two, three, four different kinds of welding, which is MIG welding, TIG welding, spot welding, and welding by robot. Then, fastening. Now, these welding and the fastening are widely used and commonly used. Then we have an soldering, that is another phenomenon. Mechanical press fit folding others. So, small components related to that, they are done. And lastly, in an adhesive, which is used for joining the two members. Now, here's a little bit information related to MIG welding. It is a metal inert gas or the gas metal arc welding, which is commonly used. It started in 1940s and still it is in use and it is very commonly used. So, it gives a high strength of the joint. So, that's why it is more and more popular. There are certain advantages and disadvantages related to that. So just have mentioned in this particular slide. Okay. Then we have an TIG, that is tungsten inert gas. Means the tungsten which is used for the welding material. And it is applicable for all industry sectors. Mechanized system, that is pipes, chemical plants, and boilers. Here we don't have to require skilled labor to operate the things and so on and so forth. less control over the arc. Careful attention has to be done while applying this particular thing. Spot welding, where the two nodes are there and the temperature rises, and because of the fusion, this welding happens. Jointing of the welding, spot welding. So these are the thing which is there, where we can have a small welding. For the minor things, we can use as a spot welding. Otherwise, it is not used most commonly, where the structural strength and what you call as stability, which is required as such. Now, this is happening. I think we can see it where the automotive and aerospace and rail and say every electronic and certain medical things which is used, this spot welding. We can see those spots. Robotic welding. Now, this is a particular phenomenon which is applicable in running industry, where we have a robotic applications are there. So we have an arc welding, resistant welding, spot welding, TIG, MIG, laser, and plasma. So now, just I'm putting one example in a car manufacturing factory. So all the operations which is there by means of robo. And it welded accordingly, and it happens. Now these are the things which is achieved by means of arc welding and resisting welding and spot welding, MIG welding and laser welding. Okay. Advantage of arc welding, it is it provides the strongest joint. Can be done on site, in the shop, or both the things. At the shop floor or on the site itself. Some corrosion and heat resistance is a thing which is taken into account while in case of arc weld. Limitations of arc welding, it is not possible to the all the grades, that is there, required qualified operators and the procedure. Many causes the heat induced disordination. Loss of mechanical properties in case of cold work material, that is a phenomenon has to be taken into account. Now, these are the certain examples related to arc welding and so on and so forth. Fastening. Now, this is the assembly of the material and which is most commonly used. Now, this is the example of it. Mechanical fastening advantage can be dismantled. Ideal for on the site, it is the fastest way of doing and not needing the qualifying operations. Limitations are not as strong as a weld that is there. And may cause corrosion, a typical kind of corrosion. Now, these are the fastening which is available for the curtain walls. Now, this is an example as such. Now, these are the other examples how the fastening is happening and what kind of thing which has to be done. Press fitting. Now, this particular thing you can see so many places like pipe fitting and railing fitting and so on and so forth. The biggest disadvantage is it cannot be dismantled. That is, once it is fit, it is a permanent one. Soldering, there are two kinds of soldering, which are soft soldering and hard soldering. So according to its use, it is applied in the industry itself. Okay, adhesives. Okay, we can paste two materials by means of different adhesives. Here, I think there is a list. I think I will show. Here is a list of different kinds of adhesives and how it is to be used and for which kind of steel which is available for us, which is to be used. Here we have silicon, polymer, polyethylene, and epoxy, and so on and so forth. So there are recommendations and non-recommendation as such. Now there are advantages and disadvantages with this adhesive bonding and so on and so forth. Okay. Now these are the certain examples of how adhesive you use and different kinds of material which is to be pasted or something like that. Okay. Here is a small presentation I have made. It is an architecturally exposed structural steel connection. This is related to only connections, means joints. Okay. Let's take a look. Thank you. Okay, last part of it. Stainless steel is a popular building material because of its durability and sustainability. Is it, now there are certain questions which is always, will is always asked, whether it is weldable or not. It is the type of welding which is used. So we have seen that particular factor. Then can TIG welds can be applied for the stainless steel for the certain process? It can be. Does welded stainless steel rust under the normal condition? Doesn't have. And preparation is a key. Once while we have a welding, a certain preparation has to be, a certain process has to be happen on those joints and so on and so forth. So these are the things. The other factor is fire design. Physical properties of the stainless steel is differ significantly than the carbon steel. So it can be used in such kind of structures, so on and so forth. But we have to rethink because of this 9/11 incidents. Fatigue, yes, it can sustain. So the ultimate conclusion that, okay, significant advantages related to use of stainless steel in structures have made in recent years, means there are development and further it is also developed. So including the publication of the number of major structural stainless steel design standards, it is also happening. So there are lot of changes which is happening in design standards and so forth. And in today's scenario, the sustainability is a major issue now. So taken into that particular account, we have to rethink about this particular, means think about this particular material on prima facie. Okay, I'm going to have my last presentation, which is related to audiovisual, the stainless steel for sustainable futures, how it can be used, considering into account the sustainability.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I thank giving me an opportunity to you to present whatever the information I have to share. And I also thank to Jindal Stainless Steel that they have given me an opportunity to present myself to this particular event. Thank you. Thank you very much. And have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you actually for being with us and actually imparting your knowledge. So hope actually we will meet again in future.
Yeah, we can. We can.
Sir, actually, students are free to ask.
No, they will ask me through the chat. I will answer, because giving the answer, it takes time and I should not cover all the things. So whatever the things are there in their mind, you can collect those and send it to me. I will send it to you. No problem.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Professor Joshi.
Any query? Okay, the students who are having any queries, please.
No, whatever the queries are there, small or big, whatever the things are, I can give that particular, because they have to be rethink a little bit about it.
Be prepared and feel free to write.
So I think they will put up the questions I will answer them in an extensive way. Okay.
Have you posted your email ID, Joshi sir?
I can, no problem. I think you collect yourself all the questions and send it to me. Okay, that will be better. Instead of having all the different questions from the different emails. Okay. Can you do that, madam?
Sir, I will do it, yes, sir.
Yeah. I my email ID is very simple. joshisir@gmail.com.
Okay, very good. But send it where is collectively, Farida.
That will do. That will do.
So everybody can send the queries to me. I'll compile it and send it to source.
Yeah, that will do.
Thank you, Joshi sir, for your active participation.
Oh.
We will have interaction.
All
the time.
Yeah.
And thank you, Jindal. Thank you, Ranesh sir, for making available Mr. Joshi. Mr. Ganesh, are you there?
He is not there.
Mr. Ganesh, Ranit Ram.
Yeah, he is there.
Professor Athawale, I'm here actually. So I was in a different call. So yes, I think it was a good session. And thank you, Professor Joshi, for your detailed presentation. And yes, whatever queries the students have, as well as the faculties, they can post them to Professor Joshi. And please mark a copy to me as well.
That's it.
To do with stainless steel, I could also give.
Yeah. You can also share certain things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Joshi sir, see you.
Yes. We can meet somewhere else. Okay.
Thank you, Professor Joshi.
Thank you.
And the second session also from 2 o'clock. The same link would work. It's a different link.
Sir, we meet on Google Meet now, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Farida, please send us the link.
So, please drop
an email. Sir, I have sent the link to you. I have sent the link to everybody, sir.
Renee, sir, I have actually sent you the...
Farida, after 1:30, I am having class with third year student.
Okay, sir.
After 1:30, I will be there.
So the next lecture actually starts at 2 and it's from 2 to 4, sir.
Okay, sir.
And the link is already shared in mail also.
Okay. The Google Meet
the
also?
The first link as well as second link, the Zoom link.
Okay.
Yeah, the
Thank
Zoom
you
link
so much,
as well
Dr.
as
Nair.
Actually, yeah, Google Meet link also.
Actually, what has happened, you know, see, because of our corporate policy, you know, WhatsApp app, the web, WhatsApp web, that doesn't open in our, you know, website.
Oh, understood, sir.
Yeah, okay, so okay. That's the reason why we were asking okay. for the mail.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you all of you. Thank you all of your students also for being here.